Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about general characteristics, which is a brief on algae, which is a class of lower plants. So in this image you see on your right there is Fucus, the upper image, and the lower image is Chara, and on your left is Chlamydomonas and Irish Moss and Caulerpa. So let's begin. The video will be about what are algae, structure of algae cell, the flagella, cell wall and mucilages, pigments and storage product. So let's start with a short brief. What is algae? The algae are thallophytes. Thallophytes are plants that lack roots, stems and leaves. They do not have true roots, stems and leaves. That also have chlorophyll A as their primary photosynthetic pigment and lack a sterile covering of cells around the reproductive cells. And talking about the habitat, where do they occur? So algae most commonly occur in water, be it freshwater, marine, brackish. However, they can also be found in almost every other environment on Earth. From the algae growing in the snow of some American mountains, to algae living in lichen association on bare rocks, to unicellular algae in desert soils, to algae living in hot springs. So there is a wide range of their distribution, the habitat distribution. They occur in a lot of places. Let us now see how the algal cells structure, or the structure of algal cells. So structure is, basically there are two kinds of cells in algae. Pretty common, we've all heard of it, prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Prokaryotic are the ones that lack membrane-bound organelles like plastids, mitochondria, nuclei, Golgi and flagella. Example being cyanobacteria, also called as blue-green algae. These also have an outer plasma membrane enclosing protoplasm, which contains photosynthetic thylakoids, 70S ribosomes and DNA fibrils, which are not enclosed within a separate membrane. Chlorophyll A is the primary photosynthetic pigment in these prokaryotic cells. Also, the primary pigment is chlorophyll A, whereas in some species they can be chlorophyll B and D also. Phycobilic proteins are also found. Glycogen acts as a storage product and cell wall contains amino sugars and amino acids. The morphology or the outer appearance in the cyanobacteria is very simple. Unicells, it could be free living or enclosed within mucilaginous envelope. Subsequent evolution led to the formation of a row of cells called trichome. If we see the first image, if we exclude the mucilage part, this would be a trichome, cells stacked on top of one another, and if the mucilage is included, it forms a filament. So when the trichome is surrounded by a sheath or mucilaginous sheath, it is called a filament, and it is possible that more than one trichome are present in a filament, and the branching of the filament causes the complexity in the morphology. Such a branched filament can be uniseriate, which as you can see in the third image, one cell on top of the other, but it is branched. So we cannot say that's a trichome. This is called uniseriate. And in the third image, where I've written multiseriate, it is, you actually see two rows of cells stacked on top of one another. So that is multiseriate. Apart from this, the cell moves by gliding movement with the help of slime secretion. We can say formedium and oscillatoria are some examples. Coming on to the eukaryotic algae, this image shows a drawing of a cell of green alga, Chlamydomonas, showing the organelles present in a eukaryotic algal cell, where C stands for chloroplast, CV stands for contractile vacuole, ER stands for endoplasmic reticulum, F for flagella, G for Golgi body, M for mitochondrion, N for nucleus, P for pyrenoid, S for starch and V for vacuole, and W is wall. So a eukaryotic cell is often surrounded by a cell wall composed of polysaccharides that are partially produced and secreted by the Golgi body. The plasma membrane or plasma lemma surrounds the remaining part of the cell. This membrane is a living structure responsible for controlling the influx and outflow of substances in the protoplasm. Locomotory organs, the flagella, propel the cell through the medium by their beating. Constant beating, whiplash-like movement is to be seen. The flagella are enclosed in the plasma membrane and have a specific number and orientation of microtubules. Usually it is made up of flagellin protein, and there is an altogether different mechanism that works in the movement of flagella, which has a lot of things. We are not going into much details there. So talking about the nucleus, which contains the genetic material of the cell, is surrounded by a double membrane with pores in it. Very similar to the higher plants, nuclear pore complexes. The contents of the nucleus are a nucleolus, chromosome, and the background material or karyolymph. The chloroplasts have membrane sacs called thylakoids that carry out the light reaction of photosynthesis. The thylakoids are embedded in the stroma where the dark reaction of carbon fixation take place. Chloroplasts are surrounded by the two membranes of the chloroplast envelope. Sometimes chloroplasts have a dense proteinaceous area, the pyrenoid, which is associated with storage product formation. The double membrane bound mitochondria have 70S ribosomes and DNA and contain respiratory apparatus. Golgi body consists of a number of membrane sacs called cisternae stacked on top of one another. The Golgi body functions in the production and secretion of polysaccharides. The cytoplasm also contains large ATS ribosomes and lipid bodies. So that was about eukaryotic algae, and we'll now move on to talking of the flagella, which provides mobility to the algae in the fluid medium. The internal cytoskeletal arrangement of a flagellum is composed of 9 doublet microtubules in a ring surrounding a pair of single microtubules, the central pair. These structures collectively compose the axoneme. This structural arrangement is illustrated in the image, and each of the outer doublets is linked to its neighbor by strands of protein called the nexin links or the nexin bridge. Each doublet also has a series of projections called the radial spokes, which is light green in color. So that is about the flagellar cytoskeletal structure. Cell wall and mucilages. Cell wall surrounds the cell membrane and provides protection and structural stability to the organism, whereas mucilage is a viscous secretion, usually of polysaccharide nature, and which has many functions. Some of the functions are to prevent dehydration, helps for gliding motility, and also holds the colonies of alga together. So here in this diagrammatic picture, you can see algal cell wall, and this is made up of two components: the fibrillar component, which forms the skeleton of the wall, and the amorphous component, which forms a matrix within which the fibrillar component is embedded. So basically the cytoskeletal part is taken care of by the fibrillar component, and the matrix is made by amorphous component. Talking about fibrillar component in a little more detail, the most common type of fibrillar component is cellulose, the monomeric unit of which is beta-D-glucose. What I mean by this is many beta-D-glucoses are joined by 1,4 linkages to form the complex polymer of cellulose, which is found in cell walls of higher plants and also of algae. On your right is mannan, a polymer of 1,4 linked beta D mannose, which is present in some siphonaceous green algae and in porphyra, which is a red algae. This is also a fibrillar component. Talking of amorphous components in a little more detail, this is very common, and they occur in the greatest amount in brown algae and red algae, Phaeophysi and Rhodophysi basically, the polysaccharides of which are commercially exploited. Alginic acid in the upper structure you can see is a polymer of 1,4 linked D manuronic acid residues with variable amounts of L gluronic acid. Also, this is present in intercellular spaces and cell walls of the brown algae. Fucoidin, the lower structure, occurs in brown algae and is a polymer of L-fucose, which is sulfated at the fourth carbon. As you can see, one SO group, S negative O3 SO, two places you can see. So this is what I mean by sulfated L-fucose. In the rhodophyta, the amorphous component of the wall is composed of galactans or polymers of galactose, which are alternatively 1,3 and 1,4-linked. So basically the linkage varies. It could be 1,3, 1,4, depending on which part of the monomer, which carbon of the monomer is trying to make a bond with the other monomer. So these galactans include agar, which is made up of agaropectin and agarose, and also carrageenan. I'm pretty sure everybody has heard of these terms. Talking of another organelle, plastids, commonly present plastids are chloroplast, which is responsible for photosynthesis, and leucoplast or amyloplast, which are colorless plastid, mainly for storage purposes.